Good morning, North Irving Baptist Church, and those of you who are visiting with us this morning, glad to have you in our worship service. Certainly hope that the week has been kind to you and God is blessing you even during the separation time and you're finding yourself closer to God. As we open up this morning, let us sing hymn number 447, Trust and Obey.
When we walk with the Lord in the light of His Word, what a glory He shed on our way. While we do His good will, He abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Not the burden we bear, not the sorrow we share, but a total need of which we repay. Not the grief for the lost, not the frown on the cross, but a blessed gift we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. But we never can know that the light of His love until all on the altar we lay. For the favor He shows, for the joy He bestows, are for them who will trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Then in fellowship sweet, we will sit at His feet, or we'll walk by His side in the way. What He says we will do, where He sends we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way but to happy in Jesus but to trust and obey.
As we talk about that through our relationship, let us continue singing, for it is just a closer walk with our Lord. Hymn number 448, Just a Closer Walk with Thee.
Daily walking.
I certainly hope that that this week finds you walking closer to the Lord. And as we come to our last song for today, if you'll share with me, it'll prepare our hearts for the word and message today. Hymn number 445, Sweet Hour.
Starting live in-person services in June, and those requirements, instructions will be coming out to you very soon about what we're going to be able to do. We know we're going to be able to fit about 50 people in here, and we're going to look and see if we need to have one service or two services. I really think as we first start off, we're just going to be needing one service, because I know a lot of you are still going to want to watch it at home. We're going to have the facilities to continue to do this from the video and on the YouTube. So you'll be able to continue to watch it at home if you feel safer at home. And I sure want you to be able to do that if you feel like that's something, especially with some of you have pre-existing conditions. I definitely don't want you coming out feeling like you have to come, or that you'll miss something. We want to make sure that we're available to you. But I know that some of you are ready to get back together again, at least in some form or fashion, and we'll be planning for that sometime in June. So be looking forward to that coming to you. Also thankful for those of you who are helping by sending your tithes and offerings in so that we can continue to run the church. Our cost of running the church is of course smaller because we're not using as much utilities, but we did still have salaries to pay and insurance and things like that to take care of. So I'm very thankful for those of you who are continuing to make giving part of your worship experience. I want to talk with you today again from Unto the Hills as we talk about how to have the upward spiral in a dark time when everything else is going down. I like to watch the show Duck Dynasty. And one of the funniest Duck Dynasties was when Willie Robertson was out at the lake with his family, and his brothers goaded him into going out and using one of these machines that you have at the lake that shoots you up in the air. You shoot the water out and it shoots you up in the air and you're supposed to fly around. Well, Willie's not the most adept at things. He's a good businessman, but as far as physical things, he has some discouraging times, I'll say that. And as he was trying to do it, he was shooting all around. It kind of was like the experience I had the first time that I went out trying to ski at the lake. I ended up draining most of the lake of the water because I sucked it up into my lungs. So that's the way, you know, it is. But as he was spiraling, trying to get around and move around, a lot of people are like that in life. And a lot of the life that we live right now is like that. But did you know that people with a positive attitude have a real special ability? We've all heard of the downward spiral, the slippery slope many fall prey to. And as the crisis comes on, their ability to deal with whatever life throws at them goes out the window. Seems people who maintain a positive attitude have learned a special power to create not a downward spiral, but in the downward spiral to create an upward spiral that can pull them out of it. Barbara Fredrickson is a positive psychology researcher at the University of North Carolina. I read an article by her that she suggests that positive emotions have the uncanny ability to create improved psychological and physical well-being over time. That is exactly what the Bible says. In Jeremiah 15:16, your words were found and I ate them. Jeremiah 15:16. I always thought that was kind of unusual, an unusual phrasing, but you know, your words and I ate them. Your words became a delight to me and a joy of my heart, for I am called by your name, Yahweh, God of hosts. And then in Proverbs 17:22, a joyful heart is good medicine, but a broken spirit dries up the bones. Some of y'all got some dried up bones out there. I want to encourage you today to try to have a joyful heart. And I want to give you some ways to do that. First of all, input equals output. See, the loudest and most influential voice you hear is your own inner voice. When you talk to yourself, what are you saying? Are you saying positive things? Or are you saying negative things? What are you reading? What are you watching? What are you listening to? Let me encourage you at this time. Find a good book. It's summer. Find a good book and read it. Don't read some book about a pandemic. Okay, that's not going to help you. And as I've said to you before, I'll say to you again, don't spend a bunch of time watching the news and finding out what's going on with COVID. That's all it's about. And it really is going to bring you down. Read things, watch things, listen to things. Listen to music, you know, that encourages you, that builds you up. Maybe some good 50s and 60s rock and roll. Or if you're a country person, some of that old, good, true country, and even symphony music. See, I'm eclectic in my styles of music. I listen to all kinds of things, but I want to encourage you. Listen and read and look at things and put your mind on things that are going to build you and take you up in the spiral. Don't take things that are going to take you down. See, the things that you say to yourself, the things that you feed on, are they primarily positive or negative? You need to be positive during this time. Take the time in your life to weed out of your life things and articles and television, not all television, but the things that aren't helpful to you, the friends that aren't helpful to you, people who build you up. Get around and be with them. You know, we need to be careful, because sometimes our life becomes a soap opera because we enjoy the soap opera. You ever watch a soap opera? People are miserable in those shows. They're hateful and they're mean to each other, and they're always in trouble, and they don't like each other, and they're always scheming against each other. They may have all kinds of wealth, but their life is miserable. I don't want you to have a miserable life. Guard your heart, Proverbs 4:23 says. Guard your heart above all else, for it is the source of life. And remember, in the Bible, your heart is your will. It is what you are ingesting into your life. Secondly, apathy creates atrophy. Apathy is the enemy of fulfillment. People don't move around when they're apathetic. They don't move and try to solve their problems. They let their problems wash all over them. If you're apathetic about something, narrow down the why behind it. Why are you apathetic about it? Are you overwhelmed? Do you feel underappreciated? Do you feel unmotivated? Do you feel like, well, if I do anything, it's not going to do any good? What are the negative thoughts that are feeding those feelings? Are you dwelling on things that are negative and tearing you down? Where you think determines where you will wind up. So think on the positive. I'm not being Dr. Schuler and trying to be positive thinking. I'm trying to tell you that your mind controls a whole lot in your life. God didn't save you and then say, shut off your mind. He saved you to redeem your mind and to give you the mind of Christ. Christ is hopeful. Christ is looking for a good, fulfilled future. Paul writes in Philippians 4:8, finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any moral excellence, and if there is any praise, dwell, think heartily, put your direction in that direction. Dwell on these things. Philippians 4:8. Thirdly, speech is powerful. Words have power. The Jews and the Hebrews, the people, believed that there was great power in words. Once words were uttered, they actually had life of themselves. The tongue holds an incredible amount of power of life and death by what we say. Life and death are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruit. Proverbs 18:21. Instead of believing, everyone hates me, I stink, I can't do anything right, I'll never change. You realize that's one of the greatest lies, one of the greatest tools of the devil? Start believing the exact opposite. Tell yourself these positive phrases that are God-given. These are not positive thinking, self-help. These are scripture. God created me. I'm His handiwork. I got this, not by myself, but I've got this with God. Keep telling yourself positive things with God's help. God can change your outlook by changing your look, your insides, where you live, everything about you. You've noticed that as you've been in this time. You've been back at your house and you've seen things that you didn't normally see. You see that you need to wash the windows or dust this or clean out this cobweb. You know that those things are there now that you're there. And you're looking at the outside, but your inside has a lot of effect. When you keep doing these things, thinking positively about why God created you. Remember, God has a purpose and a plan for your life. It not only works in you, it becomes second nature, and it becomes a response that you will have. Positivity will start flowing out of you and into others. And people will want to talk with you because not only will you encourage yourself, you will encourage them. Ephesians 2:10. For we are His creation, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared ahead of time so that we should walk in them. God wants us, in Ephesians 2:10, He wants us to be positive, encouraging people. Isn't that what we miss so much about not being together in the church? Being around our friends that encourage us and strengthen us? That is what we need, my friends. And remember, finally, strength is born from struggle. Just because you encounter a positive person doesn't mean that person hasn't had life happen to them. No one has it all together. Everyone has struggles. No one lives a threat-free life. Now, in this time, you've probably watched a few celebrities and you've probably said, well, yeah, they've got it really hard. Oh, I've got to keep myself in, and I've got a huge swimming pool in my backyard and a tennis court and, you know, 60-foot TV. Well, things are different, that's for sure. But we all go through things in life. We choose, though, to dread or to learn from our struggles. Learning will make you a witness. Dreading will make you dread. That's all it does. Romans 5:3-5. And not only that, but also rejoice in our afflictions, because we know that affliction produces endurance. Endurance produces proven character, and proven character produces hope. This hope will not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured out in our hearts through the Holy Spirit who was given to us. That's that hope that we have, that what we're going through and what we're experiencing isn't going to be wasted. And sometimes, if you're like me, You want to tell God, I'm tired of building up things. I'm tired of building patience and endurance. God is working in your life. Trust Him and pray that you'll be able to trust Him. What will 2020 reflect in your life when you get on down the road? Will you be able to look back and see how God was there for you? I truly, truly hope so. Let's pray. God, thank you for the day and thank you for your word. Thank you that you are a source of never-ending encouragement for us. Father, may we not concentrate on the stress. May we not concentrate on the difficulties. But Lord, may we always know that you have not left us alone and that you are walking with us through whatever we may experience. In the name of Jesus, amen.
What a great message. A message of hope. Once again, I had to take a couple of notes. One of the things I noticed as Peter was talking in the verses, when you talk about Philippians 4:8 specifically, you know, Philippians 4:8 is supposed to be telling us what we are to be thinking. But I read on. I have a tendency to read before and after to kind of get the context of that. And I read on. Do you know what Philippians 4:9 tells you to do? I'll sum it up. Nike uses it as a commercial sometimes. Do it. Just do it. And not only that, he says, do it. Do what you've learned. Do what you've received. Do what you've heard. Do what you have seen in me. That's what Paul says. And you know what else he says after that? Because there's always a promise behind it. He says, God's peace will be with you. God's peace will be with you. So take this lesson today. Put it into some application. You know, when PB was talking about that spiral going up, it's the same thing. I don't know if you know that or not, but it's the same thing with a collider, okay? You have to spiral up. Otherwise, you're going to spiral down. Amen? So, I guess in the 70s, they used to have another saying. I think this is a part of it, and it's something that will actually apply in our lives today. Do you want to be a part of the problem, or do you want to be a part of the solution? Seek God this week. Study the Word. Follow along with this sermon and meditate on that today. As we close this morning out, God bless each and every one of you for joining us at North Urban Baptist Church, and hope to see you in June in live and in living color. Amen. God bless you all. Sing with me now, hymn 253, Praise God for Whom All Blessings.